This is the 50th anniversary of Title IX. And this league was a pioneer and has been a leader on the women's side of athletics from that point, or even before that point on. And our next inductee embodies how this league was able to build their women's programs into national prominence and bring prestige to our campuses and to the Valley. Cindy Scott was head women's coach at Southern Illinois from 1977 to 1998, posting 388 wins and four NCAA tournament appearances, including a 1987 trip to the Sweet 16. She won 70% of her league games against some really good coaches that are in this room. Fourth best all time with 353 league triumphs, the winningest women's basketball coach in Valley history. Her team's won three league titles, finished second seven other times, three-time coach of the year, undefeated conference season 86 and 87, posting 18-0 marks, while the program won 37 straight league games in the middle 1980s. While in the Gateway Collegiate Athletic Conference prior to the merger to the Valley, Cindy Scott guided the Salukis to 8-20 win campaigns and enjoyed a streak of 15 consecutive winning seasons under Coach Scott. As Valley correspondent Brad Gray shares, the St. Louis native, yes, one of the Golden Girls, was Great Scott for the Valley.
Yeah, Coach Scott legacy here. She is SIU women's basketball.
She's a winner.
Plain and simple, she's the winningest coach.
She's one of the best at what she did, and
she brought in the best teams, the best players.
I feel fortunate to have gotten to play for her.
Hi, Coach Scott. Congratulations on your induction into the Missouri Valley Conference Hall of Fame. What a great honor, one that is well, well deserved.
Coach Scott is probably one of the most deserving coaches for this honor, just because she brought so much. I mean, on and off the court, she just held her own. She did it very professionally.
Oh, she's totally deserving, and it's long overdue, in my opinion. I'm happy for her. I'm proud to say I played for her, and know that what she's done for Saluki women's basketball will always be remembered.
When I think of my time as a Saluki, when I think of my time playing for you, I want to thank you for your intensity, your passion, your commitment, and your dedication to not only me, to our team, to Saluki Nation, and to all of women's basketball.
She got SIU women's basketball to where it had such national attention. Her and Charlotte West, I mean, you just can't say enough about what those women did for women's athletics at SIU.
Congratulations, Coach Scott. I'm very happy for you. I hope you let yourself celebrate this moment, and go Dogs.
I hope you have a great day. I hope you enjoy being celebrated and know that this is a well, well-deserved honor.
Yeah, Coach Scott, congratulations. This is awesome. I hope you enjoy everything, and as always, once a Saluki, always a Saluki.
Ladies and gentlemen, our newest inductee, Coach Cindy Scott.
Wow, thank you all so much. What an amazing honor this is. I'm so thankful and proud and humbled to be here today. Thank you to the Hall of Fame Selection Committee for including me in this year's class. And congratulations to my fellow inductees. It's so special to be a part of this class with Doug Elgin, one of the best conference commissioners in the history of college athletics. And Cliff, I watched you play at Wichita State and followed your storied NBA career. What a great player you were. And Charlie, what an impact you have made on the world of sports broadcasting. Everyone from New York to LA knows the voice of Charlie Steiner. And Carla, did you notice? My retirement came the year before you entered the league. Believe me, I knew when it was time to get out. I'd like to recognize the members of the SIU administration who are here this morning. President Dan Mahoney, Chancellor Austin Lane, Interim Director of Athletics Matt Kupik, President of the Alumni Association Jeff Gleam, Director of Athletic Development Kate Hansen, and President of the Alumni Association Board Molly Hudgens. Thank you all, our SIU people, for being here to support my induction this morning. I can't tell you what it means that you are here. Thank you. I retired from coaching at SIU in 1998 after 21 years and could never imagine that I would be standing here on quarterfinal morning of Arch Madness. I am a very, very proud St. Louis native. So to be honored in my hometown is so very special. Truth be told, my love affair with the sport of basketball began with the old St. Louis Hawks and Missouri Valley men's basketball, which was my first window into the world of college athletics. I'm so grateful to have this opportunity to thank and acknowledge the people who have impacted my life. Individual coaching honors are greatly overrated. Coaching success is never ever about one person. All of us in athletics know that. I graduated from Memphis State University in 1975 and went to SIU as the women's basketball graduate assistant. 2 years later, Dr. Charlotte West, then women's athletic director, took a chance on a 23-year-old and hired me as the head women's coach. To say I did not know what I did not know would be an understatement. But coaching was my passion, and I threw myself into trying to make our program one of the best. I was lucky to be working for Charlotte West, a national leader in the fight for gender equity and Title IX legislation. Charlotte made sure our program had what we needed to be successful. I learned a lot from Dr. Charlotte West, but most of all, the meaning of the words honesty and integrity. As we celebrate the 50th anniversary of Title IX, I marvel at how far women's sports have advanced. But I'm reminded every day that we all must commit to the continued growth of women's and girls' sports at all levels. In 1982, the NCAA started women's championships, and the Gateway Conference was formed with Patty Viverito as the commissioner. 10 years later, Patty guided the smooth transition of women's sports from the Gateway Conference into the Missouri Valley. Patty, thank you for 4 decades of being a tremendous, tremendous leader for women's sports in our conferences. Where are you, Patty? Thank you. You were awesome. The Gateway Conference was, and the Missouri Valley Conference continues to be one of the strongest women's basketball conferences in this country. There have been many great players, strong teams, and incredible coaches. During my tenure, Jill Hutchison, the head coach at Illinois State University, was the undeniable leader. Jill showed us how to respect and to give back to the game. Games were always extremely competitive, but Valley coaches had tremendous respect for one another. That lesson taught long ago by Jill still prevails in the Valley today. Assistant coaches rarely get the credit they deserve. Believe me when I say I would not be here this morning without mine. I was lucky to have several outstanding coaches during my career who all contributed greatly. My longtime associate head coach, Julie Beck, is here this morning. Put your hand, this Julie. Julie was critical to our success. In my opinion, she was the best assistant coach in the Midwest, recruiting so many talented players to SIU. I might have been the face of our program, but Julie was the heartbeat. This award is just as much hers as it is mine. I was also lucky to have George Ubelt on my staff for many years. George had been an assistant in our men's program for over 30 years and had an incredible basketball mind. So I had an X and O genius and a great recruiter. What more could a head coach want? So it takes a long time to grow old friends is one of my favorite phrases. I've been blessed with many wonderful old friends, both here in the Midwest and in Boston, some of whom are here today. Joe Hutchison, Julie Beck, Vicki King, Linda Herman, thank you all for loving me and accepting me for who I am. To my players, Petra is representing our players. Stand up, Petra. One of the greatest players that I had, a native St. Louisan. Thank you for representing all of our teammates. To my players, there's no question that you all are the reason I'm honored today. It was a privilege to be your coach. Talented, tough, and committed, you dedicated yourselves to excellence both on and off the court. All of you should be standing up here with me. Thank you for understanding my coaching passion and my intensity. I loved being your coach. Together we won championships and we earned bids to the NCAA tournament. You made me so proud and gave me memories that will last a lifetime. But most of all, I marvel at the successful women you have become and the ways you have made this world a better place. So many of you have stayed close through the years, and I am so grateful for that. This enshrinement in the Missouri Valley Conference Hall of Fame is a total SIU women's basketball honor. When I retired from SIU, I went to Bentley University outside of Boston as the assistant director of athletics and had 22 wonderful years. As much as I love men's and women's basketball, I learned to love all of our Bentley sports. Former Bentley women's basketball coach Barbara Stevens is here this morning representing Bentley. When I got to Bentley, I thought I could offer some coaching advice. I had been a coach for a while, but was quickly told it would not be needed. And I guess she was correct in that assessment, as she was enshrined in the Naismith Basketball Hall of Fame last May. Most importantly, I would like to thank my family. My brother Mitch and his wife Barb are here this morning. My brother Cliff and his wife Shelley. My niece Jenny, who is here this morning and was recently inducted into the Wash University Athletic Hall of Fame as an All-American swimmer. And my two other nieces, Lindsay and Katie. And certainly my five beautiful great nieces and nephews, Jackson, Tucker, Caroline, Scotty, and Emmy. Lastly, I'd like to thank my parents, George and Dolores, my most steadfast fans. They taught me that I could do and be anything I wanted to be. We lost my dad 30 years ago, but I know how very, very proud he is today. My mom is 93 and a half years old and a rock star. She's not only my mom, but is and has always been my role model and my best friend. I'm so very proud of her and thrilled she is here today. Stand up, Mom. Can you stand up? Again, thank you to the Missouri Valley Conference Hall of Fame for this incredible honor. On behalf of SIU Women's Basketball and Southern Illinois University, we thank you. Have a great day.
Congrats, Coach, and now we know the source of all that fire and passion. Mom.